like off-roading and things that are four-wheel drive. I also like diesels. I like adventure. So this very quirky thing that I'm driving should really make all of my wet dreams come true then. And that it does. As Adele once said, hello from the other side, because we're currently on the other side of the road, driving this 1995 Mitsubishi Delica L400 Chamon! This thing is a unit. It was actually Northeast Auto Imports shop build that I was actually present and filming for a little while until Schmovid-19 put a stop to that. But man, did this thing come out amazing. It's giant. It's taller than I am. It's got these rhino-lined coastal off-road bumpers, a spare tire rack in the back with jerry can holders, just like you'd see on a Jeep. It's riding on an Ironman lift kit. It's got a snorkel that you can hear really, really vocally when you're driving. This rhino rack, flash billet aluminum hitch, which is pulling this 2022 Bushwhacker camper trailer that we're gonna see if I actually fit in a little bit. I'm doubtful. And it's riding on these Fuel off-road wheels wrapped in some meaty Hankook Dynapro tires. Now we open the world's smallest hood to reveal what is powering this absolute mammoth of a machine. This is the 4M40, which is a 2.8 liter four-cylinder turbo diesel engine. It produces a breathtaking 140 horsepower, which makes you wonder how it moves this entire thing. Hint, it barely does. But it has 231.59 foot-pounds of torque. How's that for an accurate number? This one does have an EGR delete, and it sounds very nice breathing through a full custom exhaust. Tiny hood even has a functional air scoop. Why is it that some performance cars on the market have hood scoops, but they don't even work? Yet this 26-year-old off-road van has a hood scoop. Want to explain that one to me? It's even offset to look cool. And Mitsubishi themselves, the manufacturer that built this fine, quirky automobile, even probably knew that people weren't going to have any idea what the hell that it was. So they even left this nice little description on the side for passers-by, people who see this, see it in a parking lot or driving by it, so they can have a little description of what this is. Mitsubishi Delica Space Gear. Super select four-wheel drive with intercooler turbo. Specially designed for all outdoor players. Someone called me that in college once. Well, I am delighted to say that it's actually pretty roomy back here. Now the Delica is built to hold 7 people, and it can really do that with ease. They are very smart and they build these seats that they all flip out and flip up. And granted, this seat is nowhere near as large as the one that I'm sitting in. I definitely am sitting in luxury compared to this poor peasant that has to sit on this. But that might be an exaggeration. This is actually still pretty padded. But the Japanese are very smart in the way that they design these. It's very simple to just might have spoken too soon. Oh, I spoke too soon. Now I'm an idiot. Oh, there it is. Whew. It's very easy once you know what you're doing to just fold the seat away, give yourself a little more cargo room, and access to the back seat. Of course I'm gonna climb into the back seat for you guys and show you just how much room there is. And that's not even me actually exaggerating. My awkwardly shaped legs are just barely hitting the front seat. I'm sure they could spare a little bit of angle. They're reclined a little too far back anyways. But I wanted to sit in this back seat just because how comfortable it looks. It looks so plush, and it is. These things are like a throne compared to today's Grand Caravan seats. And I can't even say today's Grand Caravan seats because as of a few months ago, the Grand Caravan died, as it should have. And just like the middle row again, we have a seat that folds down here, or it can fold up sideways out of the way, just like an old Land Rover, so that you have a plethora of storage. And of course, all the seats are covered in this very wacky blue pattern. I wouldn't even know where to begin what to call these things. Even the carpet's got the same pattern. And of course, if you're camping in this thing, you've got all the seats up and moved out of the way. Maybe you're looking for a little private time, maybe by yourself, maybe with one or two other people. Maybe a group if you're into that. You have curtains that go all along all of the windows to give you the utmost of privacy in your Mitsubishi Delica. Yep, be with you in a minute, or like 30 seconds. And also, if you're going camping, you're taking it out, you've got too many people to fit in the van, first of all, good for you. But for a little more room and adventure, we are pulling around this 2022 Bushwhacker camper trailer. No, I'm not climbing into this thing. That's ridiculous. There's no way I'd fit. Okay, maybe I do fit, but barely. Can you give me a few moments, please? Now, when you look at this thing from the outside, and I did too, you would think it rode exactly how it looks, and exactly like me, tall and awkward. It is very tall. It's even taller with the roof rack, and the snorkel on here, the lift kit, bigger tires, but in general it's a tall vehicle to begin with. But I am utterly surprised at how well it does on the road. It has good manners, it drives straight. When you go around a corner, it doesn't throw you into the other side of the car with massive amounts of body roll. The steering is tight. When you move the wheel, it actually does something. This is not something I would expect to do that. One of the first things you notice is the sound of this thing. It's very unique. It's not like driving your dad's F-350 Power Stroke. Then again, it's half the cylinders. See, look at that, a corner. And moderately well behaved. I'm not saying that this thing handles like a Lamborghini Huracan, but last week when I was in a Toyota Century, that car literally tried to pull me out of the driver's seat around every corner. To also notice driving this is how vocal that snorkel is. Granted, I've never driven a vehicle with a snorkel before. As you guys know, I have a Jeep Wrangler. A lot of people put snorkels on Jeep Wranglers. I've been in some deep water where I probably should have had a snorkel. But because your intake is literally right there, every time you come near the throttle, you can hear it. Every little, you just hear all the air being sucked into the engine. It's wild. Let's get on it a little bit here. Just a little puff of black smoke. There's 5 miles an hour. Don't have to worry about speeding. Literally driving past the police station because I don't think we're going the speed limit yet, which is 35. Not exactly the fastest horse in the stable, I'll tell you that one. But if you're in the market for a Mitsubishi Delica L400, I don't think speed and acceleration are high on your priority list. It's got enough power to get it on the highway, get on an on-ramp. It does, well, I don't know how fast it does on the highway because it's in kilometers an hour. But I was moving right with the flow of traffic, so they must have been doing at least 90, 95. Just kidding. It must have at least been doing 70 miles an hour. Again, smooth as butter and straight as an arrow. Which again is surprising because you have all these add-ons. You've literally have this thing outfitted all for off-road and it doesn't behave like that. Usually it's the opposite. Usually you drastically decrease a vehicle's performance when you add on all that stuff. The bigger tires, the lift kit, all sorts of stuff that basically makes it slower. But I'm shocked. It's got plenty of torque to pull this trailer around on road and off the road. And to be completely honest, if I didn't just look in the mirror there, I forgot it was back there. This thing went everywhere I wanted it to go off road, did it with ease. Most of the time I didn't even need four-wheel drive. Eventually, I did need to put it in four-wheel drive. This thing even has a central locking differential. My Jeep Wrangler from the factory didn't come with a locking differential. Yet this 8-passenger giant van has one. But didn't really need the four-wheel drive off-road. Needed it a few times to avoid spinning the wheels and throwing mud all over this freshly detailed van. Sorry, Derek. This thing surprised me. It's very comfortable. The seats are comfortable. The air conditioning's on. It's nice and cool in here. I would have no idea that I have another 15, 20 feet of vehicle behind me. And for the most part, a larger person like myself, I'm 6'5", I actually fit in this. It is a little tight between my knee and the steering wheel, and I can't actually fit my hand between my knee and the steering wheel. But of course, there are ways around it. So once again, a massive thank you to my friends over at Northeast Auto Imports for allowing me to drive this 1995 Mitsubishi Delica L400. Come on! I'll include links down in the description below to their website and social media so you can check out their wide array of cars, trucks, and weird vans like this that they have for sale. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, but I will see you guys in the next one. Happy motoring! Look, we're following this GMC Econoline van, and he can't even do the speed limit, and here we are in this heavily outfitted four-wheel drive beast hauling a trailer. And I could overtake this guy. Shocker, another bicyclist. You're gonna get some coal.